dry stick making contact to drop it near center ice. That's what they've done. McInnes feeds it back. Merzen tried to shoot one in. Here's Patterson with a chance. He scores! Patterson stopping the puck at the line. He went in to score on Juan. The Calgary Flames draw first blood and lead 1-0.
Harry, it's been a story of the series for both teams, but in particular Calgary. And we see some Flames fans here. Chelios knocks the puck down right to Patterson, and he doesn't miss.
Merzen shooting the puck in. Chelios is kind of trying to get out of the way and catch it. It came right to Patterson, who made a nice shot. An underrated player, Colin Patterson. Watch him put this one in from about 18 feet out. I think Patrick Waugh thought he should have had that one. Came awfully quickly in with kind of a surprise chance.
Good play by Patterson was that he shot it right away. He didn't try to make a play. He just had it and shot it.
Assisting on the goal and playing a solid defensive role for Calgary. Skruglund up to center. He has Lemieux on the right. Lemieux's shot. It goes in! Score! Vernon couldn't handle it!
Well, there's a little luck involved in both goals. Calgary scored on a shoot-in. And watch how far out Lemieux is when he decides to shoot it. 57 feet, it handcuffed Mike Vernon. He doesn't know where it is. And by the time he finds it, it's over the red line. Scores 1-1 as Montreal has awakened all the fans at the Forum. And there's that nice slow motion shot to show you how Vernon has lost it. You can see him flick his glove. He thought it was in his glove. But a couple of flicks told him it was in the net.
Chelios coming in. Oh, the pass to Lemieux. He missed it. Penalty is over. And the Flames, four of them get out. Up to center and coming in as Loup. Gulendijk center net. McDonald scores! Matty McDonald!
What a great pass by Joe Gulendijk. He had very little time at all on the 3-on-2, but got it over quickly to McDonald. And McDonald showed you a 26-year-old shot by a 36-year-old man as he put it up and over Patrick Waugh like he did so many times for the Toronto Maple Leafs and so rarely for Don Cherry's Colorado Rockies. Look at this.
I'll tell you one thing. He was just a touch behind the play when it hit it up ice, and those legs of his were pumping, as we mentioned before. There's the good, quick release on the pass by Gulendijk, and Patrick Waugh's on his knees. McDonald waited. Waugh made the move. McDonald fired it high. 2-1 Calgary. He just came out of the penalty box.
4:24 of the time of the Lanny McDonald goal, giving the Flames the lead again. It staved off the Canadiens' attack whenever they got it going to protect a one-goal lead. If they get one here, here's Gilmore coming in. The backhand rebound. He scores! Gilmore gets that goal we were just talking about. And it's 3-1 Calgary.
Well, the exuberance of Russ Cortnell has cost his team a power play goal. And Pat Burns is applauding Denny Morrell. Of course, he didn't like the call. But Gilmore, with those great hands of his, wrapped it through the legs, out of the air, over the line. It's 3-1 Calgary.
You have to wonder if Patrick Waugh couldn't have handled that shot. It wasn't hard. Watch it. Chris Chelios doesn't stay with Gilmore. Gilmore knocked it out of the air between the legs of Patrick Waugh. With 8:58, the Calgary Flames are driving spikes now into the coffin of the Montreal Canadiens.
And Ludwig lays it out over the line. Skruglund coming over center. He's in with McPhee. Laid it off the board for Lemieux. McPhee, he's centered it now. Green gets set. Shoots. Scores! Never know. Oh boy.
Mike Vernon screaming that he was interfered with on the low point shot from about 55 feet out by Rick Green. Not known to have a great shot, but it proves if you put it where you want it, sometimes it goes in. Now watch all the people this puck goes through. I think it tipped somebody, and Vernon screaming that the Montreal player, we'll see it in a minute, Claude Lemieux interfered with him, and he did. Knocked him down. the puck was going by him.
Yes, he did.
Right there. He puts his foot behind Vernon's skate and kicks his feet out from under him. And with 8:07 to go, the Montreal Canadiens are trying to pry the coffin door open.
11:53. The time of the goal. Cardinal coming to center. Passes into Robinson. He's stopped at the Calgary line. The net is empty down there for Mullen and for Gilmore. Gilmore has a shot to win it all here. He scores! Gilmore scores! With 1:03 left, Gilmore and Calgary lead 4-2.
5 seconds after Patrick Roy got to the Montreal bench, the puck went into his unguarded net, and the Flames are ahead by 2.
And Doug Gilmore, who's been the biggest and sharpest thorn in the side of the Montreal Canadiens, so deservedly so, gets a chance to bury the Canadiens. And here it is right here.
See, now Montreal didn't get the puck inside the blue line. And Roy had already gone to the bench. They did not get the puck inside Calgary territory. Sharp angle, good shot. And Gilmore, who has in the last 3 games or so of this series, has just played tremendous hockey, pretty well puts the capper on some history in Calgary.